wearing a Star Wars t-shirt, you know? So now we know where Steven Spielberg got the name from.
Richard and Steve.
Meet love. Richard and Steve. Meet.
Love.
How you doing?
You want to have a bit of a wrap with the guys? Because they've just come back from, well, they've been back a little while, but they've been a tour.
Where'd you guys go in America?
Well, we did the East Coast, and we did the West, and we did
the
Midwest.
That's good, the East Coast and the West Coast. Yeah. Where in the East Coast?
Well, on the East Coast, we did Boston, we did New York, we did Baltimore.
No, you did all the small places.
Yeah, we did. Give it time.
What sort of venues did you work?
Oh, like mainly clubs, you know, stuff like the Tivoli, you know, 1,000-seater clubs, yeah. You know.
Where'd you play
like
in New York? Did you play the Bottom Line or the Ritz?
No, the Ritz, yeah.
Ritz?
Yeah,
do you like
good.
The Ritz?
I love it.
I hate the Ritz.
Yeah.
I won't go there.
What's
can't.
The Ritz like?
It's
tell us for people who
well, it's very...
it's an old theatre. It's a bit
It's
decaying.
An old theatre. It's a great... I mean, it's a nice place, but it's very posy, if you know what I mean. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but
it's
I don't care about that. As long as they come along and have a good time.
Yeah, well...
Well, what was the reaction? Hello over there. Good?
Yeah, it was really good.
Did they know about the church when you got there?
On a sort of a sort of underground level.
Yeah, there was an underground
film. Yeah, only two of our four albums had actually been released there.
Right. What album went out while you were over there? It was a compilation.
Remote Luxury, yeah. Mm. Yeah.
Right.
That was a compilation of our two EPs here. Right?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Did they set up a nice new way to market you in America? Was there any new plans? No major
master plan or anything. No.
So you just went on, did the stuff you would have done here. Any new songs you had while you were over there?
No, we didn't, unfortunately. No.
Now, it all came to an end at the end of last year, correct?
Yeah.
And then you've sort of split, but you only got back last weekend.
Mm-hmm.
So what did you do between December and...
Well, after we finished in December, Atlanta was our last gig. I went to Jamaica, stayed there for a while, which was great, and then came back to the States for a while, hung around for a while, and then went headed my way home, went to Thailand. Stayed there for a long while. No, it was great. Had a good time. And then I only got back. Here I am.
And Steve, you went separate ways.
Yeah, Martin and I went to Sweden for about 3 months. And then Marty stayed on and I came back.
And you did some promotional stuff in England too? What was that?
I just went on a few sort of cable TV shows and sort of weird things like BBC Radio's Armed Forces show.
All right. Have you done any of those?
Done them all.
Yeah.
What did you think of the response of America?
Excellent.
Yeah?
Excellent.
Did you play Germany at all? Have you played any?
Yeah, we have. Who are they? Who are they? Yeah.
Yeah, Germany's... I've always found German audiences to be, like, unbelievable. I mean, they're...
In fact, it's true. In fact, the best gig we ever did was in Hamburg. Like they got all the jokes.
Yeah,
it's
amazing.
They had a really good time, and, you know, they had no repercussions or anything.
It's real shocking, because you go into... I mean, the first time when I was going into Germany, you know, about 8-9 years ago, thinking, you know, because I do real theatrical stuff like Paradise and things like that, and I do, inside it, we take the songs apart and I do a lot of dialogue inside of it. So I was not expecting them
to
come across.
To understand
and
the
they
point.
Did, and I mean, they understood it better than the Americans
true.
Half the time.
Yeah, that's really true.
You know, the Americans are going, what's he saying? And the Germans go, no,
all right. Yeah.
You know. The Germans were, German audiences were unbelievable. You played Japan?
Same thing. No, not yet.
Oh.
Can't wait to see it, though. Yeah?
Japanese audiences are like, they sit through the show for all, they sit and they listen, they're very intent, and they go, right? And then at the end, they're like lemmings to the sea, man.
Really?
They're like, unbelievable. You think they're gonna, they're gonna kill you. I mean, they just like go, it's like you think they're gonna drop a bomb on you or something. It's unbelievable.
That's crazy. I found
the German audiences to be the first time somewhat that way, but this last time they were like maniacs, you know, in Sweden as well.
That's great. There is hope for the world yet, there's hope yet.
I remember playing the first time playing here in Sydney, the first show in Sydney here, there's hope for the world yet. What does that mean? Can you say that again? Did they go past me?
No.
Went right past me? Can we go?
No, I was
going
to talk
wait,
to the guys about this. You're going. You keep going.
Stop everything.
Just tell us, if I can I just break in, because we've got to get their plugs in,
okay,
too.
Okay, go ahead.
You're
plug.
Back on the road for tour with the Venetians.
Yeah, we're going to be doing 2 weeks. We're going to just do Brisbane and Sydney.
Right.
And then after that, we go back in the studio.
Here or over in America?
Sydney, yeah.
Okay. Do an album?
Yeah, do the album. And then if it goes well, then... You know, we'll go from there.
Then you go straight to Japan.
Oh, don't ever say if it goes well, man. If, Yeah, exactly. Well, we're going to do the album, then we're going to hit it, Jack. Yeah. That's what you do. It ain't if it goes well, yeah, man. Right. You just pack your bags and you're on the road.
We have a look at one of the glyphs the guys have
go
done.
For
Constant
it.
In Opal. The church. I knew it was coming. We got two great guys to help us. Richard Plug, who is in the church, and David Moore, who is actually with the church on this tour, but not necessarily in the church at all times. How are you, Dave?
Right. No,
what's the other group you're out of?
I'm a member of the Crystal Set, but I'm just sort of moonlighting with the church at the moment whilst we're in hibernation.
Tell us a bit about the Crystal Set. Are they Sydney or Melbourne-based Canberra-based?
We're sort of an underground inner city band at the moment, just sort of...
Working your way in.
Yeah. Building up a following.
Good on you. And you're playing keys with church. You'd also worked on a past album.
Yeah, I played some keyboards on Remote Luxury.
Uh-huh. Any chance that you might, Richard, grab this guy in and keep him there full time? Because you used keys the last, what,
well,
couple
no,
of times?
Well, no, he's got his commitments, you know, but we'll see what happens over there. This tour, we've got a 4-week tour ahead of us.
Yeah.
And if it works well and if he's need for his key techniques in the studio.
They might gag and bind me and make hold me hostage.
It all depends on that, I suppose, mate. Eh?
Helps.
There's plenty of that around these days.
Where is it?
The first gig the other night in Canberra was very good, and that was your first for something like 6 months.
That's
where was the
right.
last one that church played?
Well, one of the last gigs we did was at the Chevron for Greenpeace.
Right.
But I don't recall the actual last gig we did, but
uh-huh.
it's been, yeah,
somewhere
it's been...
Somewhere in November.
Yeah.
Even further back.
Well, no, in fact, we left on... Early October,
so
I suppose September, mid-September of last year.
Any nerves? First time back out again? After
surprisingly happening? Not. It was somewhat of an anticlimax. It was like, oh, here we are, back on the road again, and we just slotted into it so easily.
It was the crowds rolled up too, which was good.
They were great.
Tonight you're at Cronulla Workers, Tivoli tomorrow night, and...
Sweethearts on Monday night.
Sweethearts Monday night, which is an unusual night for them to go.
Yeah.
Just if we can talk about America very briefly, the sort of gigs you worked over there.
Well, they were similar to the Tivoli, like, you know, 1,000-seater clubs mainly. Mm. And we were averaging 200, 300. And like in New York, we played the Ritz and got 2,000. So that was excellent.
They know of you coming? Did they know of your music?
Surprisingly so. I mean, you hear so many stories about these Americans who are real Australian collectors and enthusiasts, and they're there, all right.
Really?
Yeah, we have a cultish following, which I think can be enlarged upon.
Hope so, for your sake. Psychedelia, is that moving in there a bit?
Yeah,
Prince
well,
seems to carry it with him a bit.
Yeah, well, he's got a bit of a different intent, but he's not so revivalist, but there is a psychedelic revival thing happening over there, but that's been going on now for about... 2 years from the LA scene, the Arizona scene,
uh-huh.
Boston, New York. It's pretty big, yeah.
All the way back to Flower Power, I guess.
Yeah, all those moth tops are coming out.
Soon we'll have Michael Jackson in a caftan, I think.
Okay,
yeah.
And wearing a flower in a hair.
Yeah.
We'll have a look at the first clip. Yukihiro or Yuki Taka, what did you think? Video first out of five.
Well, I don't think the video gave the song too much justice because it looked like two separate things happening there, so I'd give the video 2 out of 5.
Did you pick Ivor's voice?
No, I didn't.
It's apparently, we're told, that's him up front.
Well, I've only heard it a few times.
Yucky does it in the background.
Listens.
A bit of backing vocals. So 2 out of 5 for video. What about the song?
Well, the song's okay. It's kind of like got a punchy beat and, you know, hangs in there well, good FM radio fodder. So I'd give this song 3 out of 5.
Okay, so you've gone a halfway mark, 5 out of 10. Well, what about you, mate?
I wasn't all that impressed by the video, actually. I'd give that about 2 out of 5 because basically it wasn't all that connected to the song, I think. Although I like some of the images in it, like that sort of digital cubism sort of animation at the beginning and all those Easter Island sort of images and primitive stuff, but it looked a bit cheap and tacky to me. Yeah, it looked like they'd wandered onto a set of Blake 7 or something like that.
So it's earned itself a 2 out of 5. What about the song?
I quite like that, I've actually heard the whole song on the radio. It's really good.
What did you give it?
I'd give that about 3 out of 5.
Okay, so you both said 5 out of 10 for Yukihiro Takahashi, well-respected muso up there in Japan.
Yeah,
I love
he's
it.
Excellent.
I like
some of the guys.
He's an instrumentalist too. He plays
instruments. Great guy, and some of those in Sandy and the Sunsets had worked with him in Japan as well.
Yeah,
anyway,
right.
Second one, you'll love the. Well, I'm not sure. Uriah Heep and
I give the video a 0 out of 5 because it's so. It's so obvious and it doesn't really, you know, expand my imagination at all.
Right.
And as for the song, it sounds so much like all the other American groups, the big mega bands like Toto, Foreigner, Rush.
Do very well in the States, of course.
I'm sure it would. I'm sure it'd be dead destined to with the sound like that. It's so safe, such a safe formula. So I'd give it, I'd give that, you know, song 2 out of 5.
2, so we've gone a 2 out of 10.
Oh, you're generous.
Yeah.
You thought it looked like a movie that's around at the moment, too.
Yeah, yeah, Spinal Tap. It tends to remind me of that syndrome that a rock group can get involved in when they lose touch with why they were there in the first place.
I'm sure their amps all go up to 11.
Dave, what did you think of the sound?
The sound?
Yeah.
I thought that was almost as bad as the clip, actually. I don't know why people do it, why they continue to sort of...
OK, I'll get a score from the clip.
Oh, well,
first.
The clip,
sorry.
I'd give it sort of... Are you allowed to give minuses?
Yeah, well, we don't have it on our little digital
thing.
Machine,
well, I'd
then.
Have to give it a
It'll
nought.
It'll have to be a nought, right, okay.
And, yeah, I just thought it was rubbish. I just can't imagine why people keep doing things like that, because
really?
It's just...
But I guess there's just the market there that have grown with it that like to to get that fodder, as you call it.
Created its own trap.
It was like a parody of a heavy metal band. Like, it doesn't even look like they're taking it seriously,
right, so
which is probably a good thing.
What about video out of 5?
Oh, a nil. sorry.
No, but the
sorry,
heat
you're
right. Once, you know,
David.
The heat worked good once.
Well, I'll probably be here later this year too to extend their 11th year of touring. Nought out of 10 from Dave and a 2 out of 10 from Richard. Richard, Church's next album? We'd better move off that very quickly.
Well, the Church's next album, well, we're about to go in the studio in about 4 weeks' time.
Good.
And we've for a producer, we've got Peter Walsh, whose biggest claim to fame would be New Gold Dream by Simple Minds.
Uh-huh. Good bloke to have on your side.
Yeah, sure. So hopefully he'll add a new dimension to our sound.
So give us a release date so that we can get ready for it.
I'd say mid-August to September.
August, September. Good. Look forward to it. Mate, good luck with the Church tour.
Thank you.
Good luck with your other band, and if it happens that you move on to Church, good luck in the future. Good luck with Church, of course.
Thanks
for coming in, guys.
Yeah,
okay, we'll have a look at your first hit, 1981. Unguarded Moment, The Church.
Connected, drift away.